Welcome back to another video, guys. Today I'm going to be doing my best to deconstruct Dex's new song. You know, I absolutely love music and I've been a huge fan of Dex for probably around 2 years now. And his new song is called To Be a Man. And so it's about, you know, what it's like to be a man. And right before I start, I just want to say, who else have you ever heard of in the rap industry or music, the music industry as a whole, who's done a song like this? Let's jump right into it.
I can't hide myself. I don't expect you to understand. I just hope I can explain what it's like to be a man.
Before we go any further, this is going to be an emotional song, I can already tell.
It's a lonely road, and they don't care about what you know. It's not about how you feel, but what you provide inside that home. Yeah.
It's not about how you feel, it's what you can provide. You know, I'm only 19, I'm a young guy, but, you know, it's, I think the question we always ask ourselves as guys is, you know, are we being valued because of, you know, the value we're bringing to this person's life and how we're making them feel? Right? And is it actually us? Or is it just what we're giving, what we're providing? And yeah, I think that's, I mean, even as a young guy now, it's something that, you know, I often think about. And yeah, I could also think about it with just friends. Like, I'm making my friend feel a certain way when we're having a conversation. I'm maybe providing value in this aspect. And would I still be a good friend if I wasn't providing that? Would I still be cared about? Or is it just because of whatever vibe?
I know this life can really beat you down. You want to scream, but you won't make a sound.
It's, you want to scream, but you won't make a sound. I think we so often want to express our emotions, but, you know, in society, you know, we're told it's something, you know, we all have to work on because it's a societal norm that men can't express how they feel. And, you know, deep down, deep down, you might not even consciously think it, you know, you're suffering and you want to scream, but, you know, you just can't. I mean, I know even me personally, like, there's been so many times in my life where something happens to me and, you know, I want to cry, but, like, I simply just can't. And I think that's kind of like the conditioning that's been put into me that, you know, you can't cry. And the only times I cry is when it gets so deep to a point where it just, you can't hold it in anymore, but, you know, it takes a long time for that to come out.
Got so much weight that you've been holding, but won't show any emotion as a man that goes unspoken. Now we can't cry when life gets hard. Unconditional love for women, children, and dogs.
That's something that's talked about a lot. And, you know, the community online of men as, you know, unconditional love is, you know, only for women, children, dogs. It's like, so much of the time, you know, men aren't really cared about if you don't provide anything. You know, there's so many men that are older, depressed, and suicidal, and, you know, they can't express themselves, and their relationships are failing, and they don't know what to do, and it's like, oh, nobody cares about me, right? And, you know, it's like, can we receive unconditional love, or is it, am I only valued for what I can provide? And that's, I feel like that's a question that kind of always ask yourself.
We know that we just have to play our parts, and don't nobody give a damn about our broken hearts. Yeah, as a man, we gotta pave our way. Our only function is to work and slave. There's no respect for you if you ain't paid. You're disregarded as a human, and you can't complain. And if you
if you're not paid, and of course I'm younger, but, you know, if you're not paid, if you can't provide, it's like you're not valued. You know, and I know a lot of older men that deal with this. Is like sometimes they'll, you know, be dating a girl and it's like, you know, if you can't provide anything, if you don't, you're basically broke, you don't really have any money, it's like you can't provide anything. It's like, where's your value, right? But, you know, I think and this is just relationships as a whole with men, women, and just friendships and stuff, is like sometimes we don't see the value in people. I think we, so many people in society, you know, we value money too much, in the sense of like, you know, we'll listen to someone who has a lot of money and deem them valuable, even if they may not be that intelligent, because they have money, they must know something, right? But, you know, there's a lot of people who have a lot of money that, you know, you have no idea how they got that. Maybe they're not as smart as, you know, you may think they are. And, you know, there's a lot of people that don't have a lot of money that, you know, can provide a lot of value in anybody's life, really.
You're disregarded as a human and you can't complain. And if you ever make it up and actually reach that place and find a woman that you love and give her your last name, you'll feel the things that you provide is only why she stays. And when you try to explain, you'll say, I can't hide myself. I don't expect you to understand.
Wondering if the person you're with, and of course this isn't something I've had to deal with because I'm not, you know, up to the marriage aspect or anything close like that in my life, but I feel like that's something I'll probably think about, you know, that'll be in the back of my mind. Is there a part of her that only loves me or is staying with me because I can provide in this aspect? And what, and maybe it's not just money, it's you know, the value in this place, or, you know, how I make her feel and stuff like that. It's like, you know, is that a huge part of as to why she's with me? And it's like, you know, does she truly, deeply care about me?
I just hope I can explain what it's like to be a man. It's a lonely road, and they don't care about what you know. It's not about how you feel, but what you provide inside that home. Don't give up, keep fighting. As a man, our sun is our horizon, and our father's actions play a role, and we end up like them. So they can't let us see them hurt, because we'll embody what they do and start a generational curse. No wonder most men are so depressed.
You know, I think about that, you know, some father figures, like not being ever being emotional around your son, because like if you're emotional around them, then, you know, they're gonna adopt that, and then that'll start a generational curse, like Dax just said, you know. And yeah, dude, this song hits, man.
Play a role and we end up like them, so they can't let us see them hurt, because we'll embody what they do and start a generational curse. No wonder most men are so depressed. All the things that they can't express, they go to war, get thrown on the shelf, then go back to war with their mental health, then grab that bottle and ask for help, try to pull themselves out of hell, then fall back down and then realize that they're gonna have to do with themselves.
I've heard about so many, you know, veterans and people coming back from war, and you know, you're dealing with all these issues and you have to fight it alone. And, you know, after you go on the war, you now have to go to war with yourself. And I think just for the majority of men, you're going to war with yourself. The thoughts that you have and all the feelings that you're dealing with. It's like, you know, how do I build up the courage to express this to someone, even if I am really close with them? And that's something that maybe I've gotten a little bit better at, but still very difficult to talk about how I feel with certain aspects and situations, and even if somebody's really close to me. And, you know, that's why most men are so depressed, because they can't express, they feel as though they can't express themselves. And, you know, I used to suffer from depression and I was on medication, and man, not being able to express yourself, because the thoughts and patterns and the ideas, they just eat you alive, man. You just sit in your room all day and you're just like, man, just going on and on.
No curse, no wonder most men are so depressed. All the things that they can't express, they go to war, get thrown on the shelf, then go back to war with their mental health, then grab that bottle and ask for help, try to pull themselves out of hell, then fall back down and then realize that they're gonna have to do with themselves. It's the circle of life. As a man, you provide, they don't know what you're worth till the day that you die, and that's when they start crying. Then move on to a man to confide in.
They don't know what you're worth until the day you die. Then they start crying. Then they find another man to confide in and help them feel better. That can then provide that value to them and make them feel safe again. The circle of life. And I absolutely love Dex's vocal tonality and how all this sounds. And it's incredibly emotional, but, you know, it's the way his voice sounds and the beat, it's soothing at the same time, but, you know, it's confiding in someone else after you're gone. That's the question, you know, after it's, we're always asking ourselves the question, you know, what are we going to provide in this life? Like me doing YouTube and helping people in my own personal life. It's like, you know, I'm doing this to try and provide value. And it's like, you know, all of us a question, you know, after we die, what are we going to be remembered for? The stuff that we provided, what we did. It's not really going to be about us.
They don't know what you're worth till the day that you die, and that's when they start crying. Then move on to a man to confide in. That's why we feel we can't hide ourselves. We don't expect you to understand. We just hope we can explain what it's like to be a man. It's a lonely road. And you don't care about what we know. It's not about how we feel, but what we provide inside that home. Inside that home. That home. It's not about how we feel, but what we provide inside that home. Inside that home.
Wow. Thank you, Dex, for making the song. This is incredible. And, you know, it's nobody, I've never heard anything like this before, and anyone else express the emotions and how difficult some of these things are for so many people in the world. So, amazing song. We'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.